This thing is the Heritage Audio 609A, and it has been kindly sent over to me by the guys from Heritage Audio themselves. And today, I'm going to make a review of it. Of course. So the 609A is a Class A stereo compressor limiter, and it makes me think a lot about the Neve 33609. And that's logical, of course, because this thing is a clone. Now let's start with the most important part. Does it actually sound the same? And in order to figure that out, I've borrowed a Neve 33609 from the guys from Audio Depot, so huge thanks to Audio Depot for this comparison.
For too long, I don't know what else to do. I wanna get away from every little thing just to try to make it through. I've been thinking about my options, every detail in my head, but it doesn't really matter, nothing matters, so I cry instead.
Okay, so they sound pretty much the same. At least, if you ask me, like, they're pretty much the same. Now let's walk through this compressor a bit further. It has very nice big knobs on it, which are soft stepped. So what that means is that there's not a lot of resistance on the steps on the knobs. And that was something I really needed to get used to in the beginning. And when we're comparing it to an original Neve, it's also way more precise. For instance, the threshold on an original Neve has 15 steps, and the Heritage Audio unit has 40 steps. Now when we move on to the buttons, we see a bit cheaper approach. And that's of course logical, because the lower price tag has to come from somewhere. The buttons feel really plastic and a little bit wobbly, and I would be very careful with pressing them and using them. The cheapness does continue around the back of the unit as well. Again, no lockable XLR connectors on there. And it's getting its power from a consumer grade power cord, which, well, if you ask a lot of guys from the live and broadcasting industry, they get pretty scared of that pretty quickly. The capabilities of the Heritage Audio unit are pretty much the same as on the original. There are actually two parts on there. You've got a compressor part and a limiter part. And on both, you're getting the control over the release times, and you're getting an option of fast or slow slow attack. Slow attack is still pretty fast on this thing, and fast attack is really fast. There's not a lot of difference between those two. And of course you can bypass the compressor and the limiter individually from each other. You could also bypass the whole unit. And in the Heritage Audio, this is a true bypass done with relays, which is of course very appreciated. On the other hand, it does tick sometimes when I press the button. A very nice touch is that the view meters are actually backlit. And when you press the bypass button, the light actually goes off. So this gives you a very nice overview when it's hanging somewhere in the rack, if it's turned on or actually in bypass. There's also the possibility to unlink the compressor and use it as a dual mono compressor, so that you can use it on, for instance, a vocal, which it is also very suited for. The Heritage Audio 609A sells over here for 1890 euros, which is still a lot of cash, but it's half the price of an original Neve. So it's very much up to you to decide if this thing is worth it. The 609 has a very nice and also very recognizable sound character. And it's a very nice tool to have in your studio. Now, I'm personally going to send this unit back to Heritage Audio. And that's not because I don't like it, but I have plans to invest in a few different things first. There is, however, a big chance that I'm going to buy this thing somewhere in the future. And that's it for this review and comparison video of the Heritage Audio unit. Let me know in the comments what you guys think of this unit. I will link to Heritage in the description below as well. Down there, there's also a link to my merch store where you can buy t-shirts like this one or other ones if you don't like the logo but like some other audio engineering stuff. When buying merchandise, you're actually helping the studio as well. Now, another way to support me is by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign, which I'm going to link over here. And the last way to support me is by watching more of my videos. So I'll link one of them over here. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, keep pushing, and bye bye.